Hello guys, welcome back. So in today's video, I'm going to share with you how to use some features that are in your YouTube studios that I'm very sure that most of us are not making use of. So if you're not making use of any of these features, you might be losing a lot of views from YouTube recommendations. So like in my last videos, I talked about how YouTube recommendations is the in thing because it is favoring small channels currently. Now, how will you feel when people come to your channel or people watch your videos and they don't have that opportunity to watch more videos from your channel? So now you need to understand that, you know, YouTube recommending your videos on their home page, that is the home feed, you don't have any control over that. But when you talk of suggesting or suggested videos, that videos that YouTube will suggest to viewers while you're watching a particular video, definitely you can manipulate your videos to appear in them. So these features that I'm going to show you how you can use on your videos will help you increase the visibility of videos from your channel. Now let me just give you a few examples quickly. So I have this video that I'm currently watching. So this video is from this channel, Two Nice Empire TV. And if you go to the videos that YouTube is currently recommending to me, you will discover that there's no video from his channel that YouTube is recommending to me. And if you watch, you see that, I mean, the videos recommended here, the videos that YouTube is recommending here, these videos are somehow related to this kind of content. So if you just scroll down, like I think this video has something to do with the main video from this channel. But when you look at this video, you see that it is not from this same channel. So in all, while I'm watching this video, YouTube is not recommending any video from this channel. And this means that if I enjoy this video, I might end up not watching any video again from his channel, because other videos that YouTube is recommending or suggesting that I should watch is not from his channel. Now let me give you another example, which is a video from my channel. Now this is a video from my channel, and when you watch in the suggested area, you will see that the first video is from my channel, the second video YouTube is suggesting is from my channel, and when you go down after 2-3 videos, the next one is from my channel. So you get the point. So you see videos from my channel. So now, what could be the difference between these two videos? One, I'm watching one and YouTube is not recommending a video from that channel, while the second one, YouTube recommended about 2-3 videos from the channel. So I'm going to give you these tips on how to use these features on your YouTube studio shortly. You go to your channel's analytics and you discover that your videos are hardly found in the traffic source suggested videos. That means you need to start using these features on your videos. So for example, on my channel, this is the traffic source from suggested videos, and the videos that are suggesting videos from my channel or that are suggesting my channels are these videos. And as you can see, all of them are videos from my channel except this from Favor. You can see that all these videos are from my channel. So this means that these videos, when people watch them, YouTube recommends videos from my channel while people are watching them. So this is a very great way to gain more views, gain more watch hour session from viewers. And you know, the advantage of this watch hour session is this: when people been watch your video, that is watch maybe 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 of your videos on the stretch, it sends a very good signal to the algorithm. And with that, people that have similar interests with that kind of user or that kind of viewer, YouTube will recommend more of your videos to them. So these are some of the things that trigger virality on YouTube. So now I'm going to show you these 5 features or 5 things you need to do on your channel, that each time you upload your video, you make sure that you use this feature on your videos. The first feature that I know that most of us are not using are the YouTube cards. So these YouTube cards are those bars that comes up on YouTube videos. You know, sometimes when you see YouTubers talking, when they make reference to a particular video or a website, you see a card or a bar will appear, either white or black, depending on the theme of your YouTube app. So this is a way of linking a video from your channel to the current video. And guess what? When people click often on that card, or maybe subsequent after the video, when they click on it, it gives a signal that that video that is being added as a card on the current video has something to do with the video. So this is a way of triggering that video as a suggested video while they are watching the video. So the second one is end screen. The end screen, we all know at the end of every YouTube video, most content creators will put end screen. So that end screen is that, you know, those boxes that you see, that sometimes you see some YouTubers, they'll tell you what this video to, you know, to know some other things on their channel. So this end screen is another way, apart from, you know, adding it to your videos. It's a way of letting the algorithm know that this particular video that you use as an end screen has something to do with the current video. So when people start clicking on that end screen or the card, that is a pointer that this video has something to do with the current video. And definitely YouTube will suggest that video when other people are watching, the current video. Just like what I shared earlier on my video, you can see that I have videos from my channel be recommended to people watching this video. And if you see this person, there's no video from his channel that is being suggested. The next one is YouTube playlist. You see, this YouTube playlist is a way you can arrange your videos on your channel so that people can be watched. And the interesting thing about YouTube playlist is that when you create a playlist and insert or, you know, arrange your videos in playlist, the link from that playlist, when you copy the link of that video from the playlist, each time someone plays that video, all the videos on that playlist, and if they are your videos, will automatically be the videos that will be on the suggested column. So when someone watch a video from your playlist, you see that there will be no room for YouTube to suggest videos from other channels. All the videos on that playlist will automatically be your video. So sometimes if you are sharing your video maybe externally, it's always good to share a playlist link. That is, your video, share the playlist link of your video. It is totally different from your typical video link. There's a difference between your video link and your video's playlist link. So when you use the playlist link, when you share it, it should enable people to watch more of your videos. So, and again, apart from that, it also give that connection between the current video and other videos. If the current video that the viewer is watching is in the playlist, definitely at some point YouTube will be recommending a video, if not more than one video, from that playlist. So if you're not using playlist, start implementing it now. Then someone asked me, how did I achieve that when they went to my channel's page, he saw that both my videos and my live videos are there. So if you go to my channel's page, I intentionally created playlists on my channel's page. Both my uploaded videos and live stream are totally arranged because I arranged them in playlists. So if you can go through, you can see how I arranged this. This video is an uploaded video. Why this is a long form video. You can see this one is streamed. Why this one was uploaded. So playlist is another way of arranging your videos on your YouTube channel. But not only that, other benefits you get is that it will also help YouTube to recommend or suggest your videos while someone is watching one of the videos in that playlist. So the next one is adding your videos link in the description. You see, the description is another way of sharing other videos on your channel. And when people watch videos from your channel and then click on your videos link in the description, is another way to trigger a connection between the current video and the video the link was shared. And finally, and I discover this thing very often, and I've already, you know, shared this tip before, if you're not using related video on your YouTube short you are missing, because sometimes there's some videos, some YouTube shorts that I will watch and I would love to, you know, find out more about the channel or watch more maybe the long form version of the YouTube short. But I've discovered that sometimes the creator just leave the description blank, or where the related video leave it blank. So sometimes I will need to click on the channel's name to now start searching for the long form video. So it's not everyone that will have that patience, not every viewers will have that patience to start searching for a long form video. So to make everything easier for your viewers or for your audience, when you upload a short video, make sure that you share a link that is a related video with that short video, so that when they watch the short video, they cannot see the related video, click on it, and that will get you more views and revenue if you are monetized. So these tips are very, very important. These are way to populate your videos, around your viewers or your audience, so that when they watch one video, in matter of no time, YouTube will suggest that video to them. And sometimes when they open the YouTube app, YouTube will, you know, suggest your old videos on their home page. So this is a very great way to, you know, to explore the opportunities of, you know, increasing your visibility on YouTube. So if you're a small channel or you are new on YouTube, try implement this. Make sure that when you upload a video, add a card, add an end screen, add your video to a playlist, create a playlist probably for different sub niche on your channel, and also add a video link in the description. And finally, if you are creating short, make sure that you add a related video to your shorts. So I hope this video was helpful, and if you have not tried any of these, I would like to know in the comment section if you are going to start implementing it on your channel. And if you have been using this, and if you have a good testimony about it, let me know in the comment section. So if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and also subscribe to this channel if you want to be part of this community. Thank you guys for watching. I will see you in the next one.